Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Raz, and in this video we will discuss about how to compute income tax for an individual taxpayer who is doing business or is self-employed. So if you're ready, let's start. So before we start our discussion, let's first define what does doing business mean. Doing business means that a taxpayer is regularly engaged into business, such as buying and selling for gains as his or her primary source of income. So in short, when we say doing business, the taxpayer is doing business. He is engaged into buying and selling or producing goods which can be commercially available for the final consumers. So that is what is meant by doing business. Taxpayers doing business are said to be self-employed. They are self-employed because they are the employee of their own business. Okay, hence self-employed. Business income includes gains derived from buying and selling of merchandise if you are into retail or wholesale business, and the gains arising from producing and selling goods such as in manufacturing. An individual taxpayer, again except non-resident alien engaged in trade or business, who is doing business, is subject to either graduated rates or 8% optional rate. In our previous video discussion on how to compute income tax for purely compensation income earners, those who are considered as employees, meaning they derive their income from employment, the tax rate applicable for them is only graduated rates. But for those individual taxpayers who are engaged into business, who are doing business, their taxes could be the graduated rates or the 8% optional rate. And again, this rule is applicable only to the four individual taxpayers: the resident citizen, non-resident citizen, resident aliens, and non-resident aliens engaged into trade or business. Those non-resident aliens not engaged in trade or business are subject to 25% final tax of all their incomes. Okay, so here's what is meant by the graduated rates. This table are the graduated rates. Okay, it is graduated because the tax rates applicable is gradual. It's graduated. So it is said that if the taxable income is not over 250,000, the tax due is zero. But if the taxable income is over 250,000 but not over 400,000, the tax due is 20% of the excess over 250, and so on. And this graduated rate is applicable only from January 1, 2018 through December 31, 2022. Because we will have another tax rate, another graduated rate from January 1, 2023 and onwards, okay? But in this video, I will focus first on this tax rate which is applicable today. So always remember, if you are a business income earner, if you are self-employed, if you have your own business, the default income tax is graduated rates. But there is an instance that an 8% optional rate could be applied to your taxable income or to your income. So if the taxpayer's annual gross sales plus other non-operating income exceeds 3 million, he shall be subject to the graduated rates. So if you are an individual taxpayer, you have your own business, or maybe you are practicing your own profession, if you are a professional, if your gross sales, when we say gross sales, this is your gross revenue after you deducted the discounts, which are actually taken by the customers or your clients, plus all those other non-operating incomes which are not subjected to final taxes. If the total of those exceeds 3 million, the 3 million is the VAT threshold. If that exceeds 3 million, then you shall be subject to the graduated rates. However, if your annual gross sales plus other non-operating incomes which are not subject to final tax do not exceed 3 million, you have the option to select either the graduate rates, which covers income tax alone, or the 8% optional rate, which covers both income tax and percentage tax. Okay, so that's actually amazing because you can actually use this scheme to reduce your tax payments. So if your annual gross sales plus other non-operating income exceeds 3 million, that means you have no other option but to subject your income to graduated rates. Aside from that, you will pay the VAT of 12%. But if your gross sales plus other non-operating incomes do not exceed 3 million, that means you have the option to either choose graduated rates or choose 8%. And when you choose 8%, that 8% optional rate or bundled rate covers already two taxes, the income tax and the percentage tax. So you would save a lot of money there. Actually, we have a separate computation and separate video discussion on how to save income tax or taxes using the 8% optional rate. And I will link that video here. When can a taxpayer apply for 8% optional rate? That could be your very question. In what instance could a taxpayer apply for an 8% optional rate? Individual taxpayers can apply for 8% optional rate only if, first, the taxpayer is a non-VAT registered taxpayer. If you are a VAT registered taxpayer, then you should pay the 12% VAT because the 8% applies only to income tax and percentage tax. So hence, if you are a VAT registered, you would be disqualified from claiming 8%. But if you are non-VAT registered, meaning your gross sales plus other non-operating incomes do not exceed 3 million, then you can apply for 8% optional rate. Or when the taxpayer's annual gross sales or gross receipts and other non-operating income does not exceed 3 million. Again, that 3 million is the VAT threshold. That means that if the annual gross sales and receipts of the taxpayer is more than 3 million, the taxpayer is mandatory to be registered under VAT system. They should pay the 12% VAT. But if the annual gross sales or gross receipts plus other non-operating incomes do not exceed 3 million, then the taxpayer is not required to be subject to VAT, meaning they will be subject to percentage tax. Hence, they can apply for 8% optional rate. The other scenario wherein the taxpayer can apply for 8% is that when the taxpayer does not opt to register under VAT system. Because actually, if your annual gross sales or gross receipts do not exceed 3 million, the default is you are not required to be registered under VAT system. However, if your annual gross sales or gross receipts do not exceed 3 million, you can actually have the option to register under VAT system even if the receipts or sales do not exceed 3 million. That is optional registration. Okay? And when you opt to register under VAT system, that means you are no longer qualified to apply for 8% optional rate. So again, there are only three cases wherein the taxpayer can apply for 8% optional rate. Number one, he is a non-VAT registered. Number two, his annual gross sales or gross receipts plus other non-operating incomes do not exceed 3 million. Otherwise, VAT registered. And the other third case, when the taxpayer does not opt to register under the VAT system. Otherwise, the taxpayer should be subject to graduated rates. So who cannot elect 8% income tax rate and thus shall be subject to graduated rates? This is the contrast, okay, to what I've just discussed earlier. So VAT registered individuals, regardless of the amount of the annual gross sales or gross receipts plus other non-operating incomes, as long as they are VAT registered, they can never be qualified or can never be allowed to apply for 8% optional rate. Or those non-VAT registered individuals but are subject to other percentage taxes, 4% or 5% or 10% and so on. So the taxpayer is only qualified if he is subject to 3% percentage tax. Examples of these other percentage taxes, those operators of cockpits who are subject to 18% percentage tax. So they can never be qualified for the 8% optional rate. Or for those nightclubs they are also non-qualified because they are subject to 18% percentage tax. Also, another taxpayer individuals who are not qualified to 8% are those non-VAT registered individuals, those who are subject to 3% but their annual gross sales or gross receipts already exceeded 3 million. Even if they are non-VAT registered, but when their annual gross sales exceed already the 3 million VAT threshold, then they will be required to register under VAT system. For example, if this year 2020 and then the taxpayer who is a non-VAT taxpayer and his annual gross sales is already 4 million, the next year he will be required under the VAT system. Whether he like it or not, he should register under the VAT system because he already exceeded the 3 million VAT threshold, okay? So we also have partners of general professional partnership by virtue of their distributive share from GPP, which is already net of cost and expenses, cannot avail 8%. So later on, we will discuss about GPPs in our separate videos. So those are the four taxpayers who cannot elect for 8% optional rate. And therefore, they will be subject to the normal, regular, graduated rates. So we have here an illustration. Juan is a sole proprietor engaged in a merchandising business for the year 2019. Juan's annual gross sales, net of discounts actually taken by customers, was 2,500,000. He also earned some other incomes from other sources amounting to 300,000 pesos, which were not subjected to final tax. Therefore, Juan's annual gross sales plus other operating income is only 2.8 million. Therefore, Juan is qualified to choose 8% optional rate. So what income tax shall apply to Juan? So for the year 2019, of course, Juan will be subject to graduated rates. That is the default because it is not set in a problem whether we are talking here of 2019 or 2020. Okay, so assuming that we only have this data, so the answer would be the default graduated rates will apply to Juan's income in 2019 because it is not mentioned whether or not he applied for 8% optional tax in the year 2019. So again, it is not mentioned in the problem whether Juan elected the 8% optional rate. Therefore, the default rate, the graduated rates will apply. Okay, but assuming the same problem, can Juan apply for the 8% optional rate in 2020? The answer, of course, is yes, because our basis whether Juan exceeded the 3 million VAT threshold is from the previous year. So the answer is yes, because Juan's gross sales and other operating incomes do not exceed 3 million VAT threshold. Therefore, for the next year, for the year 2020, Juan can choose during the month of January, he can register to Bayar. When he renew his certificate of registration on January 30, he can choose whether to subject his income to graduate rates or to 8% optional rate. That is why it is important that a taxpayer should know before the year has started whether he will use the 8% or he will use the graduated rates. Because again, when you register, when you renew your registration to BAR on January, before January 30 of every year, the taxpayer will select whether 8% or graduated rates. And the basis whether he is qualified for 8% will be the prior year's annual gross sales and other operating income. So if Juan's annual gross sales and other operating income in 2019 do not exceed 3 million, therefore on January 30, 2020, in the next year, Juan can apply for the 8% optional rate. Okay, when he renew his certificate of registration to BAR every year, he can choose the 8% optional rate. So what will happen if Juan's annual gross sales and other income in 2019 do not exceed 3 million, like in this case, but what if in 2020, Juan failed to choose the 8% optional rate upon his registration? Then of course, the regular graduated rates will apply because he failed to choose the 8%. Because again, the 8% is optional. It is a privilege. So he must clearly indicate that he is applying for the 8% and he is qualified for the 8% optional rate. Okay? And he can only do so once every year when he register or when he renew his registration to the BAR. Assuming the same problem, if Juan, despite its annual gross sales, opts to register under the VAT system in 2020, can Juan opts to subject his income to 8% optional rate. So, again, in this assumption, Juan's annual gross sales and receipts in 2019 is only 2.8 million. But in 2020, it is said in this assumption that Juan, although he is not qualified or he is not mandated to register under VAT system, Juan really chose to register under VAT system. Optional registration. Can he claim for 8%? The answer is no, because Juan can no longer elect for 8% because he already selected, he already chose to subject his sales to the VAT of 12%. Therefore, he can no longer enjoy the 8% optional rate. That's it. So always remember, if the taxpayer is a VAT registered or VAT registrable or required to be registered in your VAT system, the taxpayer can no longer apply for the 8%. And in this case, Juan opted to subject his sales to 12% VAT. Therefore, he is disqualified from the 8% optional rate. Okay? So here is a summary diagram to facilitate better understanding how 8% and graduated rates work. So if you are a self-employed individual taxpayer, whether doing business or you are practicing your profession, okay, so and your annual gross sales and receipts do not exceed 3 million, and again, you have the option to choose whether graduated rates or the 8% optional rate. Again, this option is only available if your annual gross sales do not exceed 3 million. But if it exceeds 3 million or you are VAT registered, this option is not available to you. So remember that when you are choosing the graduated rates, this covers income tax alone, okay? Which means you still need to pay the 3% percentage tax of your gross sales, whatever your sales may be. But if you're choosing the 8% optional rate, this covers both income tax and the 3% percentage tax. So you are no longer required to pay the 3% percentage tax because this 8% is a bundled rate, okay? So here is how we're going to compute for income tax using the graduated rates. Again, there are several computations here, and this is the first one. So we have gross sales. When we say gross sales, this is after we deducted the discounts actually taken by the customers which are not subject to conditions, less cost of sales, and then we will get gross income from business. And then we will add those other non-operating income which are not subjected to final tax. Because again, in our previous lecture, if the income is already subjected to final tax, then we should not add those incomes because the tax there is already final. What we are talking here are those other non-operating incomes which are never subject to final tax. So after that, we will get the total gross income and we will deduct the allowable deductions. So when we say allowable deductions, this could be the itemized deductions, as we have discussed already, or the optional standard deduction, which is 40%. So you will get the taxable income. After we have computed the taxable income, we can now compute the income tax due using the graduated rates. However, there is a question. Can a taxpayer avail OSD under graduated rates? Yes, the answer is yes. Because here we have allowable deductions, as I have said, it can be itemized or optional standard deduction. And since taxpayer is availing or subjecting his income to graduated rates, therefore our tax base is a taxable income after we have deducted the allowable deductions. So the answer is yes, the allowable deductions can be itemized or OSD depending on the option of the taxpayer, and the rules on OSD shall apply. Okay, we also have here a pro forma tax computation on how to compute income tax using the 8% optional rate, which you will find out very simple and easy to compute. So we have here gross sales net of discounts actually taken by customers. Then we will add the other non-operating incomes not subject to final tax. And then we will get the total annual gross sales plus other non-operating incomes. And from then, if the taxpayer is purely earning business income, no compensation income. Again, if the taxpayer, we are talking of a self-employed who is purely doing business. Okay, we will deduct the exemption limit of 250,000 pesos. So we will get the tax base. In the tax base, will be multiplied the 8% optional rate. So the question here, can the taxpayer avail OSD under 8% optional rate? What do you think? The answer is no. No, because under 8% optional rate, the taxpayer is not allowed to claim cost of sales, isn't allowed to claim expenses or itemized deductions or any deductions other than the exemption limit of 250,000 pesos. The OSD and the itemized deduction is available only if the taxpayer is subjecting his income to graduated rates. Take note of that. So we have here an illustration. Juan is sole proprietor engaged in retailing business. Records from prior years reveal that Juan's annual gross sales plus other than operating income never exceeded 3 million pesos. For the year 2020, Juan had the following data. So again, Juan could be qualified for the 8% optional rate. So we have here gross sales net of discounts. So we have 2,550,000. We also have cost of sales of 1,720,000. Interest income from bank deposits. And we know this is a passive income subject to final tax of 20%. And we also have interest income from receivables. And we know this is from receivables, which is also a passive income but not subject to final tax. We also have gain from sale of ordinary assets. And we know ordinary gains and ordinary losses arising from the sale of ordinary assets will always be added to our gross income. We also have here gain from sale of jewelries. These are jewelries, so these are capital assets. And in capital assets, holding period will apply, if you can still recall. And we also have here losses from sale of personal car. This is a personal car, meaning not used in business. This is his personal car. So this would be subject to the rules on net capital loss carryover, if you can still recall our discussion on dealings in properties. And we also have here business expenses. And all are substantiated, meaning all are licited. We also have here depreciation of assets used in business and interest paid on bank loans. So this interest paid is actually an interest expense. However, this is subject to the limit. If you can still recall our discussion on the limit for interest expenses, and that is 33% of the interest income from bank deposits. Okay, so we are going to compute the taxable income of Juan and also Juan's income tax due. So we have here our first solution. Our first solution is we will compute Juan's taxable income using the graduated rates and using the itemized deduction. So it's actually challenging. So I really hope you have learned a lot from our video lectures so you can cope up with the discussions here. So we have here gross sales, net of discounts, that is 2,550,000. Then we will deduct cost of sales, that is 1,720,000. We have gross income from business, okay? And that is 830,000 pesos. And we will add the other non-operating income. So we have here interest income from receivables, and that is 40,000. And again, we are no longer required to add the interest income from bank because that was already subject to final tax. Okay, we also have here gain from sale of ordinary assets, and again that is another non-operating income because that is not part of Juan's business. And we also have here gain from sale of jewelries, and again holding period will apply since jewelries were acquired 7 months ago. Therefore, any gains or any losses arising from the sale will be 100% recognized. Okay, and we also have losses from sale of personal car. And since the car was purchased 3 years ago, meaning any losses or any gains will only be recognized for 50%. And that was 100,000 pesos. Therefore, our loss to be recognized here is only 50,000 pesos. So we will have a net capital gain of 20,000 pesos. So we have 40, 30, In 2020, our total other non-operating income is 90,000 pesos. And we will add this together to get the total gross income of 920,000 pesos. Okay? And from then, we will deduct the itemized deduction, starting with the business expenses. And that was 400,000. And also depreciation. And that was 30,000 pesos. And also interest from bank loans. Remember that the interest paid for bank loans was 20,000 pesos? We will reduce that amount, that 20,000, by 33% of the interest income from bank deposits, which are subjected to final tax. So it is important that you know each item and you know when to apply the rules. So as we know, interest expenses, interest paid on bank loans is deductible only but subject to the limit, and that limit is 33% of the interest income, which is subject to final tax. And in this case, we only have 30,000 pesos. So that is 30,000 pesos times 33% to get 9,900. So 20,000 minus 9,900. So we will have a deductible interest expense of only 10,100. So deducting these three items from our gross income, we will get a net taxable income of 479,900 pesos. That's it. That's how you compute net taxable income using the graduated rates and using itemized deductions. Okay, and now we will compute the income tax using the graduated rates. So we have here the taxable income, and we will look in the graduated rates table. This is our tax table. So we will look for 479, which row, which bracket this one belongs. So as we know, this is over 400,000 but not over 800. Therefore, this taxable income belongs here in the third row. So the tax due here is 30,000 pesos plus 25% of the excess over 400. So to compute our income tax, the tax due on the first 400 is 30,000 pesos, and the tax due on the excess, that is 479,900, less 400,000 times 25%. So we will get 19,975. So therefore, the total tax due is 49,975. Okay? And since there was no withholding taxes, so just zero, then the income tax due and payable is also the same as our tax due. Okay? So that is the income tax to be paid by Juan using the graduated rates and using the itemized deduction. Now, how about if Juan will be using graduated rates, but he will be using the optional standard deduction? So meaning he will not claim for expenses, and he also will not claim for the cost of sales. So our solution would be, so we have here gross sales, net of discount, that is 2,550,000, then multiplied by 40%. So we will not add yet the other income, because again, as we have discussed, the other income will only increase the deduction, and the law will not allow that. So the optional standard deduction is 1,020,000 pesos. So to compute the taxable income, we will have the gross sales net of discounts less optional standard deduction of 1,020,000 pesos. So we will get the taxable business income. And of course, we will not forget the other non-operating incomes, which we have discussed already. So we have 40,000 from interest, gain from sale of ordinary assets, gain from sale of jewelries, losses from sale of personal car, with a total of 90,000 pesos. So the taxable income will be 1,620,000. So after that, after we have computed the tax base, we can now compute for the graduated rates. And again, we will look at our tax table. So here, this 1,620,000 falls in this bracket. So over 800 but not over 2 million. And the tax due will be 130,000 pesos for the first 800 and 30% of the excess over 800. So therefore, our tax is for the first 800, that is 130,000 pesos, and for the excess, that is 246,000 pesos. That is 1620 minus 800 times 30%. So we have a total tax due of 376,000 pesos. And we will deduct the withholding taxes, which is zero, to get the income tax due and payable. So in this case, if you will notice, using OSD is not a better alternative for Juan because it would only increase the income. Because remember in our previous assumption, there were many expenses, there were many deductions, but using OSD, Juan's deduction is only limited to 40%, and that is 1,020,000. So this is not a better alternative for Juan. So now you have the idea of how to compute the income tax for your business. And I hope by at this point, you can now imagine, you can now appreciate the income taxation in the Philippines. Aside from the income tax, whether using itemized deductions or OSD, the taxpayer shall also pay 3% percentage tax based on sales. As again, I have said, if you are subject to graduated rates, aside from the income tax, you'll be paying for the 3% percentage tax. And that is computed as 3% of the sales. So we have here the total tax due under graduated rates using itemized deduction. So this is what we have computed in our first solution. So the percentage tax due is 2,550,000 times 3%. That is 76,500. So under the first assumption, Juan will pay a total tax of 126,475. So this 126 covers already the income tax of 49,975 and of course 76,500. However, in the second assumption, Juan will pay income tax of 376,000 and of course a percentage tax due of 3% of the 2,550,000, and that is again 76,500 with a total of 452,500. But we still have one assumption, and that is the 8% optional rate. So if Juan elects 8% optional rate, this is what will happen. We have here gross sales and net of discounts of 2,550,000 pesos, and we will add the other non-operating income of interest income from receivables, gains from sale of ordinary assets, we have gains from sale of jewelries and losses. Again, we have discussed this already in our first assumption. So Juan's annual gross sales and other non-operating incomes is 2,640,000 pesos. We are no longer required to deduct the cost of sales and the expenses because the tax base for the 8% is the annual gross sales and other operating incomes in excess of 250,000 pesos. So we will deduct that 250,000 from our annual gross sales to get the tax base of 2,390,000. And from then, we will multiply by 8%. That's it. And we will get the tax due of 191,200, which is, by the way, composed of income tax and percentage tax combined. So that's it. That's how easy to compute the 8% optional rate. Again, this is under the assumption that Juan is earning incomes purely from business and no other incomes, no compensation incomes. Okay, so that's it. So we have here a summary. Under graduated rates using itemized deductions, the total taxes that should be paid by Juan is 126,475. While under graduated rates using OSD, that is 452,500. While under 8% optional rate, the income tax and the 3% percentage tax combined is 191,200. So that's it. So I think in this case, Juan should better choose to claim graduated rates under itemized deduction. So I hope you learned a lot from this video, and I hope you will watch the other videos that you have about the computation of income taxes for other taxpayers. Okay, thank you so much. Bye-bye.